वेलकम डे स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे द लेक्चर इज द मटेरियल कन्वीनियंस. इट्स अ पार्ट टू. सो इन दिस मटेरियल कन्वीनियंस वी आर गोइंग टू कवर क्रेन्स एंड हॉर्स एंड ट्रक्स एंड आल्सो द रेफ्रिजरेटेड एंड अनरेफ्रिजरेटेड ट्रक्स विच आर यूज्ड फॉर इन ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. वेल द कंटेंट ऑफ द लेक्चर द मटेरियल हैंडलिंग classification of a material handling, mainly bulk and unit. Two classification we have: the principles of material handling, transport equipments, the types of cranes and industrial trucks. In detail we are going to learn about the things. Welcome to today's lecture. Dear students, today's lecture will mainly concentrating on the material conveyance equipments that are cranes and hoist trucks and also the refrigerated and unrefrigerated trucks. Well, what is the content of lecture? The material handling, what is the material handling? The classification, that's mainly bulk and unit. The principles of material handling, transportation equipments, the types, that's in detail, the cranes and industrial trucks. We're going to see classification and its and refrigeration and unrefrigeration trucks. So what is the need of temperature to be critical while storage as well as the transportation, the recommendations of the storage temperature for some fruits and vegetables. It has been mentioned the post harvest treatments, like in a pre cooling treatments, various treatments we'll go to see. Modes of transportation, what are all the modes of transportation are there, and then refrigeration loads we'll see, and the types of cargoes or transport vehicles. So with this I'll wind up the class. Well, so material handling is size and complexity. A material is handled system it consists of a two components. That is, one component in which the material handling, one is the physical flow of the material, the other one, another one is then a corresponding information will be carried out. That means the material which is carrying, which consists of a physical material as well as the information along with the its status. So in this one we can see the information is on one side, it's the two parallelly they will move the information, that say for sake of the control, for sake of the physical movement of the material, that's the material handling. Right, so information, why it is needed? The accurate control, track of the status of the material, provide the information on the inventory data. The material handling, transportation, lifting, these are the modes of the material handling we can see. And further it is, what are the methods used for an information to be procured? Is manual, by manual, by visualizing the material which is handling, the information can be gathered, or mechanization and automation. Similarly, the methods in the material handling, you can see manual, mechanical and automation. So these are all the examples of the information gadgets. These are all the examples of the material handling equipments. So as I told, the major classification of the material handling, the materials are two classification. It comes out, that is the unit and bulk materials. So we'll see what is a bulk and what is a unit and all those. So bulk handling, the material which is handled in a volume. So that is a unpacked form, that is a bulk handling. So usually these type of a produces can be handled in a bulk. That is dry powder, granules, and coals, resin, fertilizers, etc. So likewise, the bulk handling materials are characterized by a continuous flow. There won't be any breakage in the flow, unlike the unit handling. The elements which are all involved in the various elements in the bulk handling. So mainly here you can see the conveyors which comes under the bulk handling. So apart from that, so these discharge devices and flow aid devices, maybe trough side, hoppers. Well, the unit handling are separate, discrete, and ranging various sizes. Maybe nuts and bolts, pallet loads of the bag, car bodies, aeroplane. So these are some of the examples of the unit handling. Right, so automatic assembling lines of the various industries, they incorporate this unit handling, material handling equipments mechanism. So in this unit handling, you can see the common elements in the unit handling. That's the lifts are the one of the common elements, the conveyors and overhead cranes and hoist also comes under the unit handling. So various equipments, various types of options are available in the unit handling, since the handling is in a packed form, unlike the bulk handling. The special attention has been given for in a material characteristics in the bulk handling, okay, whereas unit handling is not required. Well, the principles, there are total 20 principles are involved in the material handling. These principles mainly talks about the material handling and its properties and its replacement or its installation. We'll see the orientation principle. Orientation means the material, the equipment orientation to be subjected for the near to the process, if it is a continuous process, right? So that is a orientation principle. The planning. The planning is nothing but, say for example, the receiving to the outlet point. So it has to be well planned. Say for example, we are receiving the material over here. From here to here, there is the purpose of the supply. So we have to plan from here to here, it has to move. So accordingly, the material handling equipment has to be established. That's the planning of the systems. So as I told, the system, it should be systematic principle and unit load principle. That's a packed, it should be packed principle, and space utilized principle. So as low as the space has to be utilized and in order to get the maximum productivity. So that's a standardized principle, ergonomic principle. Yeah, the ergonomic principle mainly concentrating on the reducing the human drudgery. So likewise, we have an energy principle, ecology principle, mechanization principle. Mechanization principle is nothing but it's a principle which is mainly involved on the mechanization. Maybe automation is one of the principle which talks about mechanization. Flexibility, simplicity, gravity, safety, computerization, system flow principle, layout principle, cost principle, maintenance principle, and absolute. Absolute principle is nothing but, so once it has comes to any wear and tear, so it has to be easily discarded. That's a absolute principle. Material handling equipments used for movement and storage of the material within the facility or on site. So material handling equipments can be classified into five major categories. One is a transport equipments. So the equipment used to move the material from one location to another. So major the classification of the subcategories, the conveyors comes under the transport equipments, cranes, industrial trucks, etc. So positioning equipments, mainly these positioning equipments used to handle the material at a single location. So unlike these transport various locations, it's a single location taking the produce and positioning. So that is the positioning equipments mainly they are using. So the material, unlike the transport equipments, they can be placed at one place and they can be operated. Unit layer formation equipments. Unit layer formation restricted material so that they can maintain an integrity when handling. That means they can form in a compact larger size of the material and they can handle. That is a unit load formation equipments. Right, storage equipments used for holding and buffering the materials over the period of a time. That is a store. Examples we can quote it as a silos and storage structures. And identification and control, this what is called, that is an information equipments. Information, mainly the information has to be transferred. Well, in this, the transport equipment comes out to be the five classifications. Again, A, the conveyors, which we have covered in the earlier, the various types of conveyors used for depending upon the material characteristics. In today class, the cranes, mainly the Jibe cranes, bridge cranes, gantry and staggery cranes. We'll see in detail about the classification. And industrial trucks are mainly classified in three broad categories: that hand operated industrial trucks, then the power operated industrial trucks, and automation, that is a automatic guided vehicles, AGV vehicles. So these are all the under umbrella of these three classifications. The hand operated, so these are all the things comes out, and power operated, some of the power based upon the power, and the automatic guide vehicles also, three categories under the industrial trucks. The positioning, what are the positioning equipments? We can see the lifts is one of the best example for any positioning, and so similarly the dock lever and ball transfer tables positioned, and it will be operated for an handling of the material at the position place. The manipulators, industrial robots comes out of the positioning, and unit load formation equipments. These are all unit load formation equipments. So that is pellets, skids, sheets. So in storages, we can see the skids and pellets, the major role over the pellets and skids we used to keep the material for a storage as well as the transportation as well. So likewise, the bags, bulk load containers, maybe silos comes out. So these are some of the classifications of the unit loads. However, we are going to see only two in detail explanation, that is cranes and the industrial trucks, right? So these are the storage equipments. The storage equipments are these things, right? The block stacking, the drive throw rack, drive-in rack, and pushback racks, sliding racks. So all the storage, say for example in the library, so whatever you have in a rack, that is a storage equipment, right? So just for any sake of a knowledge, I have the difference of use of conveyors, cranes and industrial trucks with respect to their path and area as being given in pictorial depiction, that the conveyors are having the fixed path of a motion, whereas cranes are having the variable path and the restriction area. And whereas industrial tracks, unlike conveyors and cranes, they are variable paths and unrestricted area because it's movability. Well, we'll see about the details of the cranes and hoist. So what is the crane? The cranes are used to move the material over the variable paths, as it was stated, with the restricted area. The major types of the cranes are jib cranes, bridge crane, gantry crane, and stacker crane. Generally, equipment with these cranes consist of a hoist rope. Hoist rope is nothing but the cylinder or pulley which is winded with a rope is known as a hoist. So that is wire ropes and chains and sheaves. These are all the major components of the cranes. that is it is the crane is equipped with mainly the waist rope, or it is a wire rope or chain, and shears, and that can be both used to that is lifting and lowering of the material, which are mainly horizontally movable. Right, jib crane. So as you are seeing, the pillar, that is a, we can state it as an the pillar which is standing will be having an horizontal arm which is attached to an hoist trolley. Hoist trolley is nothing but a the pulley, or it is a the cylinder which is winded with an rope, winded with an rope. So that is known as the hoist rope. So mainly it is in a arm like working, so similar to our arm it works as, and it can be function as an manipulator for the positioning task, mainly the positioning, taking out the material from here and it positions to another place. That means it can rotate the 360 degrees of the angle. The waist also moves, that is this entire structure moves along with the arm, you can say it as. Next is a bridge crane. As we are seeing about the bridge crane, the bridge, that is a the mounted the track is mounted on a opposite walls of the facility. So these are all the opposite walls of the facility. So it's a track, we can say it as. This is the structure, what is a bridging of the crane. The crane, this is the crane structure. Okay, so the it enables three dimensional so here we can see the horizontal movement. So it can move in this 360 degrees of the motion, whereas this one three dimensional, that is x axis, y axis, x axis and z axis also it can fetch for its material movement purpose. And the top riding, the top riding and under riding, this the track, if it is the riding is top, so that is a heavier material will be handled, and if it is the like an underriding monorail, right, so that is a versatile type of a bridge crane. Well, next one is a gantry crane. Gantry crane is it can be single leg. This is a single leg gantry crane, and double leg, and some movable. You can see the caster wheels over here. It can move wherever we want to operate the craning operation. That's a lifting of the lowering and positioning of the material. That is mainly unit materials, unit handling. It is similar to the bridge cranes, except that the floor is supported on the both the ends instead of the overhead. Here it is similar to the bridge crane, whereas these pillars are supported to the floor, whereas unlike the earlier one that is supported on the pillars, okay, that is supported on the pillars, this is on the floor. This is a floor, okay. Used to span a smaller portion of work area compared to the bridge. So smaller because of its the dimensions and its size, the smaller area, this movability, compactability it can, and the smaller area of the operation can be suitable for handling the materials. So stacker crane, here you can see the overhead crane comes here, the stacking of the material. So this is known as the stacker crane, which will be having in a pokes, and it is having in a mast. These are all the mast. So the vertical pillars are the mast, and these are all the forks. The vertical pillar with the projected forks, that is known as a forks, it acts as a platform to handle the unit loads, and then they will be stack the material. Mainly the material will be stacked, is used for any stacking of the material. That is a stacker crane. Well, that is about the cranes and hoist. We'll see now the industrial trucks. The industrial trucks, so used to move material over variable paths with that is mainly the horizontal paths, so with no restriction of the area covered, that's the unrestricted area of the movement of the tracks. That's a material handling equipment. So it provides vertical movement as well if the truck is having a lifting capability. If it is having the lifting capability, not only horizontal, it can also go in a vertical operation as well. So when used, there is an insufficient volume. So smaller areas of the volumes or smaller cubical structures of the areas can also be adopted to transport or handle the materials using these industrial trucks. Okay, provides more flexibility in movements. Yes, as I told, every nook and corners of the smaller cubes, it can be operated. It provides more flexibility. The not licensed can be traveled to travel on the public roads. The commercial trucks are traveled on the public. So here these industrial trucks can be traveled within the industry or outside the industry. If it is within the industry, no license is needed. If it's outside, it is a licensed industrial trucks, we can see. So classification, students, here we can see the hand trucks. So mainly the trucks which are all operated using the hand within the warehouses, manufacturing, shipping and distribution. There are different types we can see. Just we'll say dolly. You can see the dolly type, the which is the smaller, inexpensive platform type of a load carrier. It's a platform type of a load carrier with a handle and which is having usually capacity of 2,000 to 3,000 lb capacity. So shorter distances it can be used to operate. So two wheel hand. This is a two wheel. So pneumatic tires or pneumatic wheels we can use. So simple would be level with wheels and moving material of the heavy and awkward to be carried out. The most common the capacity of the up to 1,000 lb we can carry using this one, because we are using the only two wheels. So hand lift, here you can see we are having an the forks, and here there is an hydraulic mechanism in the hand lift. So using the pressing of the handle probe, we can lift the material to any certain heights, and it can be operated with this. So and then the approximate capacity 2500 to 500 lb, because it is a mechanically power, that hydraulic power will be there. Then the power lift stacker. The stacker means you can see the power is attached to an electricity power. The stacker, the fork, you can see the forks which can lift the material up and down. That's a vertical movement as well as it moves horizontal movement as well for handling of the material. Then the power trucks. These power trucks, mainly the walkie trucks. So they walk the trucks. The power trucks operated by walking behind, like walking behind, we are seeing the farm equipments. There is a walker type of a rotavators and etc. So like that, there is a walkie trucks. Then we have to walk behind the truck and it has to be operated. But the power is the mechanical power. The handles are controlled. So they have the different types. The low lift walkie trucks is a power operated, and the straddle walkie truck. And then counterbalance walkie truck. Mainly these major classifications of the verification, you can see the material handling in capacity as well as the area of the axle operation. Axle is the space between, say for example, this is a track and this is a wall and this is a wall. If the small axle is available, there's a pathway. So it's available. So the straddle type of a walkie can be operated. That's with help of the power to handle the material from one place to another place. This horizontal as well as the mechanical, horizontal as well as mechanical. So similarly, that is a counterbalance. So where it the balancing of the material in counterway, and it will be handled. So that is a counterbalance power truck. So rider. So in the walkie, we have to walk. We have to walk behind. Whereas rider, so it is a seating arrangements will be there. The electric counterbalance rider trucks, it's mainly made up of the pneumatic wheels. The three wheel sit down rider truck, the four wheel stand up rider track and four wheel sit down rider track. So mainly the capacity of the riding as well as the area, the length of the truck, it varies. Whereas in case of the electric counter balance truck, the clean, quiet and operation indoors, mainly this indoors, in some of the outdoor service also this can be used, and the pneumatic tires will be wheels which are all operated for in a riding. And three wheels, the capacity 2,000 to 4,000 lbs, the combines that's a maneuverability in the tight quarters, the flexibility counterbalance is operated. The four wheel stand up, the capacity 2,000 to 4,000 lbs for continuous demanding duty cycles. When ability to ride, the increased operator productivity and the comfort, the stand up design reduces the necessity of the truck length. The mainly this the four wheeler, the truck length will be very small, and sit down, the heavy duty continuous work, the major, the stand up, the low risk, and this one is the heavy duty. As well, the quantity of the material handling will be vary. So electric narrow axle, so this especially the rider type of electric narrow vehicle, which is which can be permitted to reduction of the cost, axle space, and more efficient using the buildings of the cubicle space, because the cubicle space buildings does not have any turning radius, more turning radius. So therefore this narrow vehicle can, that's a truck, can be operated in the cubicle area. Automatic guided vehicles, that is commonly known as AVG vehicles, they can reach the capacity 2,000 to 6,000 lbs as a pantographic mechanism that extend forks beyond the base legs. Various pallet sizes and racks opening can be accommodated in the AVG vehicles. Deep reach versions to permit too deep stacking and eliminate the axles are available. So without the any path available, that is axles available, can be stacked using the automatic guided vehicles. So in automatic guided vehicles, we have in two types, that is order selector and the heavy duty order selector. Selector type of AVG having the capacity of 2,500 lbs, a quick selection of item to fill the orders. It operates rides platform to stop the heights. Whereas heavy duty order selector, the capacity is 2,000 lbs for bulky items such as furnitures, handles, and operates on the platform similar to that of the order selector. Well, now the refrigerated and unrefrigerated trucks.